are you supposed to set up a podcast interview? Like, what kind of tools do you need? Do you need a special software? Can you do this online? Does the person have to be right there in the room with you? Like, seriously, how does this work? Well, don't worry, my friend, because I'm going to cover everything that you need to know in order to conduct an amazing podcast interview. So let's get right to it. Hi, I'm Crystal, and I'm so happy that you're here today to learn about podcast interviews. Oh my gosh, because if you have checked out any of my other podcasting videos that you see right here, then you know how much I love to talk about podcasting. So I want to get into all of the nitty-gritty details that go into a podcast interview. How do you get it set up? How does this work? What tools do you need? So let's walk through the step-by-step process that you need to do in order to have an amazing podcast interview. But I did want to tell you that this video isn't about how to actually find guests. It is assuming that you already have someone amazing that you're going to interview, and I'm going to show you the step-by-step processes that you need to put in place in order to conduct your interview successfully. So let's talk about it. What are the tools that you need? For what we're talking about today, the first tool you need is Calendly, which is what we're gonna use to schedule your interview with your guest. The next thing is Zoom, which is what you're gonna use to record your interview with your guest. And the third thing is Google Docs, because you gotta stay organized and you have to make sure that you have all the information in front of you while you are recording your podcast interview. So let's just jump on into all of the details. I'm gonna share my screen with you and show you exactly how to set up each of these steps. So let's go. So like I said, this is Calendly.com, and this is what I use to schedule my interviews with all of my guests. So you can create a free account right here. And then once you have that set up, you're going to go into your dashboard. So this is what the back end of my account looks like once I have created an event. This is for the Profit Podcast, my podcast, and I send this link right here to all of my guests whenever I want to schedule a podcast interview. But for the purposes of this training, I'm gonna show you what it's like to set up a brand new event. So you're gonna go to New Event Type. And then once you create that, it's going to say, you know, a one-on-one, or you're gonna have multiple people, but we're just assuming that you're talking to one person on your podcast interview. So I'm gonna click Create. A one-on-one, and we're just gonna call this podcast interview, okay, for the event name. For location, I normally just put Zoom because that is where I conduct my interviews. And then description and instructions. For here, I normally put something like, be sure to hop on Zoom 5 minutes before podcast interview. But you could customize this whatever you want it to say. The event link, this is what you want. It just makes your link look really nice. So you could put podcast interview. My main one is named podcast interview, so it's defaulting to something else, which is fine. You could make it say my interview or just something simple. You can just totally make it custom. It's up to you. And then event color, I try to make something that's closest to my brand colors. So that's the closest. And then I'm gonna click next. And then this is where it gets really cool. So you can choose how long you want this interview time to be. And then, you know, how many times in between sessions can people book their interviews? So I'm just gonna put 60 minutes. If you are planning to talk to someone 45 minutes to an hour, I think it's good to just put 60 minutes. Or if you think your interview is gonna take at least an hour, maybe it would be nice to put 90 minutes. That way the person knows how much time they need to set aside for your interview. And then here, I just leave this at what it defaults to. It means that 60 days will show up on the calendar for them to choose. If you wanted it to be longer or shorter, then you can edit that. My time zone is central. You can update this to whatever time zone you're in. Availability. This is what I love about this app. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I can choose, you can choose
what days you want to do your podcast. So this is what I love this so much, y'all, and I'm totally geeking out about it, because if I don't want to have a podcast on Fridays, if I don't want to do interviews, then don't do interviews on Fridays. Simply click on the day of the week that you want to edit, and I can click I'm unavailable and apply to all Fridays. Boom, it disappeared off my calendar. But I also don't want to do Mondays either, because I like to get, you know, my planning for the week ahead done on Monday. I don't want to dive into something brand new. So I'm going to click I'm unavailable on Mondays. Boom, apply to all Mondays. So that leaves Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Well, I know on Tuesdays and Thursdays, I can only do interviews between 1 p.m. and 4 p.m., let's just say hypothetically. So I'm going to click on Tuesday, and I'm going to enter my time here. Oop. 1 p.m., not a.m., come on. Oh, hang on. 1, I'll get there eventually. 1 p.m. to 4 p.m., okay? And that is the only time that I want to be available to do my podcast episode interviews. And I'm going to apply that to every single Tuesday. So it updates right here. So you can continue to do this for every single day of the week that you want to be available. Or if there are specific days, you can click show more. And if there's, let's say you knew you were going to be out of town this week, you can go ahead and mark I'm unavailable only for that day. I'm unavailable only for that day. Oh wait, I didn't click I'm unavailable. So if you are out of town for any reason, then you can have it. But what's really cool is Calendly also syncs with your Google Calendar. So if you already have something, let's say you had an appointment on Tuesday at 2 o'clock that you forgot about, Calendly automatically reads your Google Calendar and sees if you're busy or available. So as long as you keep your Google Calendar current with any other appointments or, you know, big projects that you're working on, then everything's gonna update accordingly, and it works like a charm. It's so awesome. So I'm gonna click next. And then you have it set up. So I can only, because I'm on the free plan, I can only have one set up at a time. So I actually can't go through the entire process of creating this up, but I do want to show you the other options that you have. And then I'll show you how this looks on my invitation if I were to send this to you to be a podcast interview for the Profit Podcast. So you can have the person's name and email. And all I did was under additional options, I clicked invitee questions. And then here, I think that this is a cool opportunity to ask them to send you their bio. So please share anything that will help. We'll just say, please share short bio and any links you want mentioned in your podcast episode. So I swear I can type and spell, but apparently not today. So, okay. So, and I want it to be multiple lines. Sure, you can check whatever boxes apply for the question you have, apply. And then you can add one more other question if you wanted to, you know, have something else in there. Is there something else that you need to know beforehand? Then have them put them in here. And then I'm going to put save and close. And then there's a notification and cancellation policy. If you upgrade, then you can have a text reminder sent or an additional email reminder before the interview is, like, before the time is ready, the scheduled time. But for the purposes of this, like I said, I just use the free version, so save and close. And then payments, I don't do payments because I don't set up anything that someone would have to pay me. I guess if you did like a consulting call, you could do that. But the confirmation page, I just have it defaults to everything here. If you wanted to redirect to somewhere else, you'd have to upgrade like a special thank you page or something, but it's okay. I'm good with this just being how it's set up. So I want to show you how this looks like on the live page for the Profit Podcast interview. So we are going to actually go to the live page. So this is what your guest would see if they clicked on the link that you share with them. So it says the name of my podcast, and you'll set this all up whenever you initially set up your account. And then it says a 1 hour call, Zoom, be sure to have the show guidelines prior to the scheduled interview time and hop on 5 minutes before your interview. So this shows you the actual dates that I'm available. So someone could click on a Thursday and say, oh, she's only available at 3:15. You could click on another day and there's multiple time slots. So let's select 1 p.m. This is where the questions are that you set up on the back end. This is where they show up. Please provide a short bio. What will you be promoting on the podcast, and put your links in. So this is exactly how a guest would sign up to be on my podcast. And what's really cool is once this is all done, there's a dashboard that shows you all of your upcoming interviews so you can make sure and keep your calendar straight.
I want you to comment below if you have used Calendly or another scheduling tool for your podcast. What has your experience been? I know that there are a ton of other tools out there, but I didn't even know that they existed until I was a guest on someone else's podcast. So I want to know if you've used these scheduling tools, which one is your favorite, and all the other good stuff. Okay, back to the tutorial.
Okay, so now that you have a podcast interview scheduled, we're going to talk about Zoom. It is what I have been using for podcast interviews, and I really like the setup and the ease because people that are still a little hesitant with technology have found it really easy to use. So you will go to zoom.us and create a free account. And then once that's set up, I want you to go into My Account. And then you have a personal ID. This is specific to you and your account and no one else. Like, it's very unique to just you. So this is what you are going to share with your guest whenever you're ready for your podcast interview. And for the purposes of this training, I'm going to pretend like I am my own podcast guest, as weird as that sounds. And I'm going to copy this URL and paste it into my browser. And then because I have Zoom installed on my computer, it's actually going to open up in another window. And then it asks you, do you want to join with computer audio? Yes. And now it says you are using computer audio. If I wanted this to be a video call, I would click start video. But because I'm doing this screen share right now, it won't allow me to actually share my video. But what's cool is whenever your meeting is going and you're sitting here chatting with someone, you don't actually have to do video, by the way, if you don't want to. You can just do audio only, but then you can hit record. So now I am recording myself while I'm recording myself, as weird as that sounds. But you can see right up here, it says recording. So I typically wait until like we've, you know, kind of just chatted for a few minutes and got caught up and make sure that the guest doesn't have any last minute questions. And then I will hit the record button. As you can see, it's recording, we're talking, we're doing the interview and everything's fine and dandy. And then whenever we are finished, I simply hit stop. And you can see up here, it says the recorded file will be converted to an MP4 when the meeting ends. So while I'm in the chat room, on the back end, it is compiling our file. So I will close this and have an actual file. As you can see, it says it's converting it. And now I have a file in here that I can use for my podcast.
So I'm curious, are you trying to set up your very first podcast interview, or are you just looking for a different platform or a different way, a new strategy to conduct your podcast interviews? So put in the comments below whether this is your very first time to do an interview or you're just trying to change things up. Okay, now let's talk about Google Docs.
Now the last thing we're gonna talk about is Google Docs. I've talked about this before in other videos, but I love Google Docs and having everything accessible on the go, and I can update things on my phone anytime I need to. But for the purposes of today, I have my Google Doc open somewhere, whether it's on my phone or I have two screens set up. So I will have a Google Doc open during the interview while I have Zoom open on another screen. This helps me stay organized and it helps me make sure that we're covering all the important topics that we need to hit during this podcast interview. So this is a recent interview I did with Maykay Sang. And this was episode 77 of the Profit Podcast. And this is the actual outline that I used during our interview. So I know, okay, these bold titles are something that happens, you know, on the other end. It's when I'm like, I record those myself. And then this is my self-sponsored ad. And then this is the bio that she sent to me before we did our podcast. So this is what I collected in Calendly. I showed you that earlier. And you can set this up. So they send you their bio, and it's one less thing that you have to do. You have to make sure that you collect that from them, because I mark it as something that they're required to do before they even finish scheduling an appointment for our podcast interview. So these are the questions that I asked her, and I keep my interviews very simple, and some of them are the same from time to time, depending on the guest. Like, tell us your backstory is something that I tend to ask most of my guests. I just say it in a different way. And then these are the questions that we went through. And then we had some rapid fire questions, and then an area where I said, okay, can you tell me a little bit more about where people can find you? And then that's it. But I think it's so important to stay organized. That way the flow of your podcast, it goes really well. And if you're interested in learning more about podcast format, I encourage you to check out this video. That way you can see exactly how you need to set up the flow of your podcast. Because whether you do a solo show or an interview, it's usually the same. Like, it's not much different from doing your own podcast. It's just that you have to collect, you know, you have to have a bio, and you have to have the interview, and maybe some other things at the end, but it's basically the same. So that is how I use Google Docs within my podcast interviews.
And there you have it. Now you know how to set up podcast interviews. So hit that thumbs up if all of this made sense. And I want you to comment below if you have any other questions at any time. But be sure to check out all of the other podcasting videos that we have, and make sure that you subscribe so you're notified every time a new video comes out on Fridays. Be sure to sign up for our free 5-day Create Your Podcast Bootcamp, where you're going to learn the basics of podcasting. So make sure to keep it up, and remember, we all have to start somewhere.